Dude, it's Christmas Eve, and we're gonna go test out those new brakes and see how that does. Let's get it.
Dude, I got on these NBT pants, these Aramid armor pants. See how those things do too. Engaging fuel pump. Oh, baby. So, Merry Christmas. We gonna go for a ride.
Oh, dude, this is so nasty. Oh, I'm sure the bike just got all nasty. It doesn't look like it, but it's slippery. And on a leader bike, it's extra sketchy. Ah, it feels good. Dude, I just got on a hoodie and a t-shirt underneath. Don't do it. Thank you. They've got a good bite. Keep in mind these pads are brand new. So we're kind of doing some progressive little stops there, but feels pretty good. Look at that lever. Woo. So far so good. The brakes feel good. My fluid level isn't dropping or anything weird. We'll check all the lines when we stop, but yeah, lever feels solid. Everything's working as it should. They definitely feel like they have a little bit stronger of a bite than the Takikos we had on there before. Keep in mind these pads are brand spanking new, so we're still kind of trying to scrub those in. Just doing a little series of progressively harder stops. But so far, right out of the box, everything feels pretty good. Christmas Eve, baby! And it's gonna rain. It's like 95% chance of rain tomorrow. It's gonna rain the whole freaking day on Christmas Day. So like, well, I'm gonna get out and I'm gonna just take a little quick cruise, test these brakes out. I've had them on for about a week. So I've just been dying to throw my leg over this thing and check them out, see how they do. Been busy with work. I am wearing these MBT pants, these License to Ride Aramid pants. They have that Aramid lining on the ass and I think in the knee area. They've got the like the CE rated armor inserts to help protect your body in case you take a dive. So if we like these things, we might do a little review on them or something. But first ride so far so good. They're very comfortable. This is how you winterize your motorcycle. You just don't stop. Fuel stabilizer. There's definitely times, you know, January where it's just like too bitter cold to get out there and really just like you could do it, but I wouldn't enjoy it if it's, you know, in the teens. That really sucks. Oh. Oh yeah, see how that could have turned bad real quick. Good thing we got some gangster old brakes to just rah, slow us right down. Oh, that's all front brake. And she bites. She bites like a shark, boys. Ooh, a chair. Oh, hello, vultures. Like, these are all the things I say in my helmet when I'm not recording, so it's just like, come on, you know you do the same thing. Man, Kentucky is kind of bleak in the wintertime. At least the sun can still pop out, you know? You got sunshine there. It's not like Michigan and Ohio. It seems like that's just gray. But, yeah, it's pretty cold, man. Obviously, all the leaves fall off the trees, and it's kind of a dull place, I guess I would call it. What up, Jesus peeps? That church used to be a movie theater. It's like the first movie theater we ever had, like, in town, like, around here. And then, bam, COVID happened, shut it down, and it became a church, which supports my Dollar General and church theory. Church, Dollar General. I'm telling you, man, they go hand in hand.
Oh, there's no fluid. Everything is all good. Try to steal my identity, I dare you. I am McLovin. The legendary Pearl's Food Mart.
Hey, what's up, man?
Oh, yeah. Doing, doing. No, guys, I won't drink these in one day.
There you go. It's because it's all wet. All right, have a good day.
Ooh, look, debris. Dude, that was a U.S. bank bag. Dude, that said U.S. bank on it. Like it's a deposit bag. All right, well, we're going to have to do a flipperooski on this one. Dude, what if we find that bag and it's like full of somebody's money and we save it and rescue Christmas? Pretty sure it said U.S. Bank on it. Dude, how wild would that be? We're gonna stop right in the middle of the road. Oh, dude, it's a U.S. Bank beanie. But it did say U.S. Bank. And I would have picked it up, but unfortunately, it was soaking wet. Yeah. Win some, you lose some. I wish it feels good. It's very interesting, you know, no ABS, especially with your, you know, your front and rear brake. You're trying to find and walk that line. Like, how much can I apply before I lock up and wash out? You don't have a computer making those adjustments for you. You kind of gotta to feel that yourself through the lever. And I like that. Much more DRZ content coming soon. Probably be doing some work on a VTX 1300 here soon as well. Bike my dad owns. Need to get it back in tip-top shape. So we'll be probably doing some, a carb rebuild and some other things to that. So stick around for that. Who knows exactly what that will entail. We're just having fun, man. Are you from around here?
Well, I mean, I'm in the corn stand. I've never been on the
Both ways will take you out to Cedar Grove Road. This will just kick you further down. So this is Ridge Road. You come out a little bit closer to Shepherdsville. This way kind of puts you a little bit closer towards Bardstown Road. Yeah, both are pretty good little rides. Yeah. Yeah, see you guys. Have a good holiday. I can brake with one finger now. It's great. Oh, back wheel broke loose a little bit there. It said, "Let me do what I want to do." Little wheelie there. Oh yeah, dude, the front end just stands up and just says, "Arr, I am a 1000. I want to do 1000 things." Dude, this curve right here, this one, if you're not paying attention, will get you. And when I mean get you, I mean it'll land you off in the Chattahoochee. Actually, the Chattahoochee, I think, is in Mississippi or something. I don't know. But it'll flick you in the creek is what I meant. Yeah, man, feels great just to get out for a couple minutes. Just feel the wind and experience life for an hour or so. Can almost always manage to squeeze in an hour or so here or there if you really want to. Oh yeah, you can't get through here, huh? Off-roading. Hooligan. So, look at that front, just that little bit of pressure. Look at that, it just stops you. Okay, I definitely think we made the right choice with the R1 Sumitomo monoblock calipers and that Brembo master cylinder. Because what a difference, man. What a difference. Yeah, dude. So that bridge we were on, I know somebody that tried to kill themselves and they jumped off that bridge and the water is only like 7 inches deep, so instead they just broke both their like femurs. Where's this ambulance going? Oh, ambulance. Got them good brakes, boy. This bike is so smooth. It's silky smooth. Bumpy there. Oh, oh, oh. Look at people dump their trash, man. Freaking TV and bullshit out there. That makes me so mad. Like, dude, it literally requires no more effort just to go dump it in a dumpster somewhere. Even if you do it at the freaking... Dump it at the Waffle House or the rallies or something, man. Every one of them's got a big dumpster out back. Instead, you just gotta throw it over the hill. Just don't, I just never understood it. Dude, it should be $500 fine for littering every piece of litter. Does anyone know anyone who's ever been fined for littering? Oh yeah, dude, those brakes are so good. Still pretty wet up here, no matter how it looks on camera, so that's one ramp away from jumping off about 1,000-foot cliff. No shit, it's 1,000 feet in elevation right there. So that's a long way to the bottom. Not a single guardrail on this road either. Just hoping that an oak tree stopped you. So you gotta take it easy. Thank you. That dude was blowing the leaves. He saw me coming. At least he waved me down. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, man. All right, well, if you guys made it this far in the video, I appreciate everybody for watching. Till next time, thank you and take care, and we'll see you in 2024. I believe it's a 20-year-old bike because it feels so good and sounds so good. And now it stops so good. Does it stop like an ABS-quipped BMW S1000RR? No. But does it stop really good? Yes. And there you have it. Great lever feel. Love it.